heavy waiting to get the return on reusable bottles. Seems to me there may be some issues with lightweight glass breaking and then ultimately getting to a consumer and having some issues.
Well, by comparison, you can, if you use 100% cullet to produce the same amount of product, it's costing you about 10 times more in manufacturing costs. So we feel the return there is astronomical, like within months you've already returned your initial investment by doing this procedure.
Thank you, Purdue University, our time has expired.
I introduce Preston, and on behalf of the Kreiner Operations Club, he has a few sort of announcements to make, after which we'll go into a break. During the break, we'll process all the information, and we'll have the final decisions. So I'll hand it over to Preston.
Thank you, Dr. Iyer. As you said, I'm Preston Lehman, the president of the Kreiner Operations Club. On behalf of the club, I wanted to thank everybody for coming today. The Kreiner Operations Club is the largest club at Purdue, or in Kreiner, with over 60 members. Our mission is to give students the industry exposure they need to be effective managers in the workplace. And we accomplish this by having guest speakers, participating in Kaizen events, plant tours, and case competitions like today, which is actually the Operations Club largest event of the year. Every year we start organizing this event in September, and we encourage teams from all over the globe to participate in this competition. As part of that, we do offer an early bird registration, and for those teams that participate in that, we enter their names into a drawing for a prize. And I'd like to do that drawing right now. Daniel Schwartz from Purdue University won. Thank you, Dan. That was not rigged, I promise. You will get a top-of-the-line, brand-new, wireless, all-in-one printer, and your team members will be getting t-shirts. So, thank you. As Dr. Iyer said, we're going to take a short little 10-15-minute break, and then we'll announce the winners and have some closing comments. Thank you.
Okay. If you can all have a seat. Again, just a few comments before we go to the very concluding end. As Preston said, the whole planning for this conference begins as soon as we're done with our fall manufacturing conference, fall operations conference. So it starts somewhere on September, where we try to find speakers who are gracious enough to share their time. There's a whole bunch of students involved, as you know, the Kreiner Operations Club, Kreiner Graduate Student Organization, etc. And more importantly, it's all of you, visitors, guests from all the schools. You're what makes this happen. And so just on behalf of Purdue University, on behalf of the Kreiner School of Management, thank you for participating. We genuinely appreciate your interest. We completely understand that your faculty have to play a role. Just interestingly, all of your faculty are talking to us in the background. So, you know, they call us and ask, how do the teams do? So we know many of them. They're our friends. And this is truly a learning opportunity. So to begin with, this is year number 5 that we've been doing it, but every year we send you a request for feedback. And we truly want that feedback, because the plan is to create a process whereby you enjoy the experience, you know, we all learn jointly, we engage with industry. So first of all, give yourself all a very big hand, and a big hand to everybody who's here. Again, at the start, I said Mary, who's running around somewhere, and Valinda. So these are, Mary and Valinda are our staff. Mary's managing director of the center. Valinda is our administrative assistant. They are the people who make everything work. They're the contact, so please continue to contact us and continue to remain part of this, part of our effort. What is our effort? Our effort really is to expand problems related to global supply chain management that get closer to what is happening currently out in industry. And the reason we're doing this is, I mean, if we're all educators, we can all sit around and wait for the Harvard case to come out. But we know that'll come out 2 or 3 years from now. Well, how do we remain competitive? Well, there are a bunch of things we do. All our cases that we develop, we work with companies and we allow them to give us a context. So that's number one. All the cases are posted and available for free for everybody to use. All the presentations are videotaped and are available on the website for people to learn from. So this is truly our effort to contribute to the whole education process. So again, part of what we hope is many other schools continue to start down this path, and therefore we get, there's a whole ecosystem that develops. So those are the few things I wanted to bring up. Within what we hope will also happen is that as you think about these cases and as they get adopted, we're also hoping that it'll create a dialogue that'll expand the definition of what constitutes global supply chain management. So there is this, what we might call, I mean, for those of us as faculty, we're going to spend our lives doing this, which means that the more fun it is and the more interesting it is and the more challenging it becomes, the more we can act as sort of people who are out there convincing more of you to take this as a field. What we're going to do as part of process is recognize all the teams. Every team will either get a certificate or just the first, second, and third teams will get a prize. This time, since this is our, there is a check that goes with it. The check will come later because you've got to pay some dues to a guy called Uncle Sam. There's that little detail. So we'll get all your information, and Mary and Valinda will coordinate to get you all those details, which means the winners will have to stay aside and, you know, stay back and do some paperwork. So without further ado, I'm going to announce the names. First of all, I want to recognize that all six of you are the finalists amongst potentially 28 teams that started and 23 teams that submitted. So regardless of what happens, you've done a fabulous job. So you should feel very good about yourself. Sometimes what happens is it's like a marathon, or even if sort of a short sprint, the difference is in picoseconds, for example. So just that. So let me announce the winners in reverse order. So the sixth place goes to Indiana University, and if I can have a representative come up. The procedure we'll do is hand over the certificate and get a picture. Actually, if we can have the whole team come, that would be great. I'll stand this way so we get a picture. Okay, thank you. Okay, the fifth place award goes to the University of Michigan. Can I have the team come up? This award goes to the University of Akron. This award goes to Purdue University. Okay. Okay, here I need to be a little precise. The second place award goes to team number 2 from University of Minnesota. Of course, if this is a quiz and there are 6 teams and I've announced 5, there's only 1 team remaining. So the winning team is from the University of Minnesota and they call themselves the Gophers. Says, as you know, associated with comes some checks, and the checks are ready? Okay. Sorry?
Oh, that's right. The first, second, and third place get checks, and the exact amounts are?
Ah, they've signed the paperwork. Okay, so when you sign the paperwork, we give away checks. Our usual plan is to give away about $8,000 in prizes to the top 3 teams. So you'll get the associated checks in a few minutes. Again, thank you very much for coming. I hope it's been an enjoyable day. Remember as you leave, the message in the bottle. And if at all you get a copy of The Police and Message in the Bottle, just look at the lyrics. One of the things that's quite amazing is how well it captures the sort of story of the bottle. This is used, of course, as a metaphor to get a discussion going. It's been amazing to see, at least as a person who was writing the case, as I was imagining various scenarios that people would look into as I was putting it in the case, it's amazing to see the variety of, sort of ideas that are emerged. I think what I'm hoping is that you take the compendium of all of the ideas, and I think there are many, many things to look at. Certainly, from the perspective of case, you always sort of balance out what to put in, what directions can people go, and I'm always amazed at the innovativeness of the teams as they look at these things. So the good takeaway for us on the academic side is that even though the whole concept of sustainability and how it will pan out is in its infancy, if the energy that all of you bring in the table is any indication, I think it has a bright future. So thank you very much. We look forward to seeing you again next year. Thank you.